We've talked to Bridge before about their keyboards, but this year they've come out with something new. They've got a trackpad for the iPad. And I'm with Nick Smith, one of the co-founders of Bridge, and he's going to, he said he could possibly tell us a little bit about his products.
A little bit about it. Look, thank you. So what we've done here is we've taken our core iPad Pro keyboard, which has just been an absolute stellar product for us over the last 12 months. The idea of what we create is a keyboard that really does complement the iPad and give it more of a MacBook style or feel to give you that extra flexibility and productivity. With the release of iPad OS in, you know, back
I was 13.
iOS, sorry. No,
iPad OS 13.
iPad OS 13, you're right. There wasn't 12, but... it's obviously allowed accessibility features, and one of those features is touch, assistive touch. So what we've been able to do is create a touchpad that complements that experience. On one hand, we've got one that's actually built into the keyboard itself.
Why you were pointing at that one. I didn't catch that.
Which is the new Bridge Pro Plus. It comes Bridge 11.0 Pro Plus or the 12.9 Pro Plus. But we've also got this standalone trackpad. And the idea behind this is really to complement those customers or those users who focus on the iPad as their primary device. Whether they be at home, sitting at their desk, they might have this sitting up on a holder or a dock, and use a magic keyboard. This trackpad means you don't have to go and touch.
Right.
You can be sitting back, and it has sort of really three main functions. Obviously, we've got a tracking experience here, but to be able to navigate, three finger tap. If I go into, say, settings, hit my three fingers, that brings up the dock. If I hit two fingers, that brings up App Expose, and that allows me to then be able to swipe left and right and select what I want. I can then go in the bottom right-hand corner and click, and that takes us back to the desktop. So what we're trying to do is to provide an experience that really just does enhance the usability of the iPad itself, and give that user probably more pro capabilities or Mac OS style capabilities on their iPad, because let's face it, these devices are ridiculously powerful. They have the power of a MacBook in many cases, but the flexibility of the iPad. So what we're about is all providing that blend of experience.
Bring it together. Well, I'll tell you another thing that you may not realize how important this is I do video screencasting, and one of the most tedious parts of the job is to add the touch after the fact. Yeah. So with this trackpad, you could then be using the touch, and the touch targets are there. You can actually see the cursor moving around, so we don't have to add those touches after the fact. So that saves us money, saves us a really annoying job, too. It's like no fun at all to do it. It's boring as all get out. So this has a huge impact on the production for the video podcasting. And it's interesting because the trackpad from Apple doesn't actually work very well with the iPad. But I haven't been able to get this to do anything but exactly what I expected it to do, so I think it's working really well.
Look, we've tried to create a more simple product. You know, I'm a firm believer of less is more. And at the end of the day, of course, this is smaller than the Magic Trackpad 2, but that's enormous. And this is really just an alternate solution, which, quite frankly, is actually designed for iPad OS.
Right. And the thing is, I mean, I love my giant Magic Trackpad, but awesome. If I'm on a little iPad, that doesn't make any sense at all.
It's nearly as big as the iPad. So, you know, as I said, this is for that user who uses their iPad all day, every day. But when they're at home, just gives them a bit of an extension. Of course, on the other hand, you have the solution which is here, which is obviously the bigger version, which is our Bridge Pro Plus. And this is a product that's designed, obviously, to take that trackpad experience but bring it into a single, you know, iPad solution. But at the end of the day, if you still want to use your iPad, out it comes, and it's unencumbered in a beautiful case, and it is what it is.
So for the audio listeners, he's got the 12.9-inch iPad Pro in a keyboard with a trackpad, and I mean, that is that's a full-fledged computer right there.
Exactly, and it still gives you those same functions. So whether you're wanting to, you know, bring up the dock and change things around, or be able to change through apps and just be more efficient, more productive.
Yeah, that is fantastic. So one of these trackpad versions is going to be available.
So these actually started, went on sale yesterday at 11 a.m.
And what you're pointing at is the keyboard with the trackpad?
Yeah, exactly. So the first 500 units are shipping at the end of February. They're gone. The balance is going to be shipping at the end of March.
That happens every year with you guys. You should learn to make more than 500 off the bat.
They went in literally 60 seconds. So it was, it was crazy. So,
that is crazy.
This will be going with it as well. The independent touchpad will be at the end of March as well.
Will be at the end of March. So you're going to call me when that's coming on sale so I can get it in the first 60 seconds?
First number. No, absolutely. That'll be different. That'll be fine.
So the iOS, the iPadOS trackpad is going to be $129, yep. And the
11-inch Pro Plus is $199, and then the 12.9-inch is $229.
Okay, great. This is fantastic products. I wish you the best of luck.
Oh, thank you so much. Good to see you again.
Thank you.